Well, there are times in your life when you realize you're in the company of greatness, and that's what we're feeling right now. Our next guest, Nancy Elizabeth Lieberman, carved out record-breaking history in the world of basketball and on a national and Olympic level, and she's joining us right now to give her takes on this March Madness, and it is madness that's going on right now.
Oh, my goodness.
No perfect brackets left in any of these big competitions,
no,
right?
No, Warren Buffett, you're safe with your $1 billion, okay? But my bracket was busted when Duke lost. Mm-hmm. And I started getting texts from people, NBA players, going, dang it.
I was going to say, how many people before March Madness called you and asked you what you thought?
I probably helped about 30 people fill out their bracket. And
and those 30 people lost out immediately.
They all lost out, but these games are amazing. Look, I played in two Final Fours. We won back-to-back national championships at Old Dominion. It is the coolest moment. That was 30 years ago for me. Okay, 35. And I still remember it like it was yesterday. It was that, the enthusiasm and the pressure of the moment is fabulous.
Well, I'm really excited because my Bruins are still in it, and I was actually at UCLA when they won their national championship in basketball. But what do you think about our Baylor Bears? They're hanging in there, huh?
They had a rough patch during the middle of their schedule. But they are playing so well right now. See, now I have Florida winning it all, but there's a lot, you know, with Iowa State getting ready to play Connecticut in Madison Square Garden.
Are you rethinking that at all now?
I'm just going to stay away from it and just hope for the Mavs that well, they do well.
They've got to play UCLA this week, so we'll see. You know, I got my Bruins, but that's so exciting. And what are you doing with the Final Four? It's coming to town. How are you involved?
Well, I have been on the local organizing board, so Charlotte Jones Anderson has been our leader, and it's been absolutely phenomenal. Wait till you see what happens here the week of April 1st. There are so many great events. We have Bruce Springsteen coming to town.
What?
He is performing free. We have Tim McGraw. Yeah, good looking Tim McGraw.
So basically no one's going to be at work that week.
No.
Everyone will
take the week off. We're going to break every record for attendance at AT&T Stadium. It's just been painstaking details. I'm so proud of the NCAA and our local organizing committee.
And are you going to be hosting anything and getting up there?
Lots. My foundation's dedicating a dream court with the NCAA and the Big 12 and World Ventures Foundation April 1st in Arlington at the Boys and Girls Club.
Can you tell us about that a little bit if people aren't familiar with your foundation?
My foundation is a children's foundation, and you get a chance to see. Those are the dream courts that we have built. April 1st, we are dedicating our 11th. That's me. That's right. I'm bringing sexy back.
Love it. But
we teach children. We have literacy programs. We sent two young men to college last year. There's so many things. We have laptop programs. We do so much with children in the schools, in education.
And the dream courts that you build, are those in neighborhoods where the kids don't really have a place to gather and play basketball?
That's where I was. Look at Billy Crystal over there. We built one for Billy in New York, where we grew up in October, November.
Love.
But it's for children who didn't have that environment. A dream court for me was a safe place. No judgment if I was a woman, young, old, Jew, Christian, white, black, it didn't matter. You got your street cred, and your safety net was the court and the people around you.
And you've passed that on to your son, right? Tell us about TJ.
Well, TJ is a sophomore at the University of Richmond. He's now a Richmond Spider.
Okay.
And he plays basketball. He's 6'8", and about 230, and he has 3 years there. And it's just so cool when your son loves what you do. He played at Plano West, had a great year there, and I'm just so proud of him. And
is it hard to watch him play, though? Is it hard, like, do you find yourself biting your tongue because you want to?
Absolutely.
You want to coach him?
Absolutely. But he has to do his thing. Yeah. When TJ calls me and says, "Ma, will you help me? Will you train with me?" That's when you know you've crossed that respect line with
awesome
your child.
What an awesome feeling that must be.
But I also beg with my kid now. I beg him to come because he's the Pied Piper at my camps. The kids love him. And then, you know, my dream ball, April 17th, my kids got to be on stage with me, right?
Okay, right, tell us about the Dream Ball very quickly.
Well, April 17th is our third annual Dream Ball. It's the largest fundraiser of the year for my foundation. We're honoring Diana Nyad, the great swimmer.
I love her.
She will be there. We will raise money to give scholarships to college. Emma Smith, Deion Sanders, Mike Madonna.
So you've got two Dancing with the Stars people.
Yes, absolutely. So we have it's star-studded. It's at the Omni.
Perfect.
And if anybody wants to buy it, all we have are tickets left. 972-473-2121. Or go to nancylieberman.com if you want to buy a ticket to be a part of us.
Perfect. Well, you definitely don't want to miss that. We love it. Thank you so much for joining us here today.
Thank you.
All right.